noise coming down after the water, but everything's okay.
You don't need to talk about this, do you? This is lovely to watch. You know, an Egyptian. You know, only one individual. And making this look very easy and very competitive too. Look at the way he's galloping to this. Can he leave all these three up? Oh, up to his neck, and she jumps it for him.
Look what a round.
The sole rider from Egypt goes into sixth place. Almost certain, that's my calculation.
I reached 142 a couple of weeks ago, which I believe in the horse sport is not very high. But after the World Championships in Kentucky last year, I realized to enter the best shows in the world, I gotta reach the top 100. And I didn't have the horses for it, but I realized the only thing I have to do is to go weekly on a show to try to reach the top 100, and now I'm 142, but now I'm having a holiday for 2 weeks here in Egypt, which I love, and I think I'm gonna drop some points these 2 weeks, but I hope to reach the top 100 so in 2012 I can ride all the good shows before the Olympics, get my horses ready. It's very funny for a rider to tell him you have a championship, because a championship is something very serious for a rider. You start preparing for. And I know I haven't been, I've been to 8 championships representing Egypt. And the most thing about a championship, the most difficult thing about a championship is to get with your horse in a top condition to that championship. And I've never had the opportunity to ride horses long enough for a championship. And I think the longest horse I rode before a big championship, whether it's Olympics or World Championships, was about 11 months. And people prepare for years. And for me, I didn't have that opportunity yet. But I know it will come. When you believe in things, they will come. And the dearest championship of all the championships I've ridden for Egypt was actually, funny enough, the Arab Championship in Egypt in 2007, because I was not even on the team. I was the fifth rider of the team until a day before the show, because my horse was injured and I had to ride a horse that was eliminated with me a week before, which was not my horse. And he ended up finishing second, silver medal, both teams and individual. And it was very funny that if you really believe in it, you can do it. And I know we can all do it if we believe in it. And championship is just another show. And let's hope the luck is on our side next time for Egypt. Concerning the Olympics 2012, I don't have a horse yet, but I'm trying to find some horses. I think I found a horse that has been jumping the 135 classes a couple of weeks ago, and I'm famous in the horse world that I can do these things with horses. But I hope that this horse will prove that I had a vision, and one of these horses will prove that my vision is right. That it's about believing in the horse you have, no matter what is his capabilities. One day Egypt will reach also one of these championships with the team. I believe we are very close. But in our culture in Egypt, people go to universities, people become doctors, architects, and they really don't have the sport mentality that when a kid is out of school, they can just send him to become a sportsman, which happens a lot in Europe where I live, and in America and a lot of parts of the world. And I think Egypt has lost a lot of time because of that, because we are more than 80 million and about less than 500 sportsmen, except footballers for sure, but less than 500 sportsmen, all athletic sports. And I think it's a shame for more than 80 million to have less than 500 sportsmen in the country. But I believe, considering the horse, the show jumping actually, that we're almost there. because we have a talented rider like Abdel Eder Said, and we have another rider called Samah Dahan. I heard he's in Europe lately and he's doing good, and I believe he's also a fantastic rider. I believe Egypt is close to having a team, and I think when we all get together with all the difficult times we've been through, we're going to be a very strong team. And let's hope the younger generations don't make the same mistakes we did and lose time, and their parents will realize that the sport is also a career. And let's hope Egyptian people will realize that soon, and that's how we're going to have teams in all sports in the Olympics.